Hey everybody, Curtis here. Thanks for tuning into my channel. Today we're going to be doing the top five, one, two, three, four, five tips for new owners of the FiFish v6 and v6s. Stuff that I've come up with in the last few weeks since I've owned mine. But before we do that, please do me a favor and hit the subscribe button and notification bell, hit the like button, and please leave a comment, especially if you've got a tip that you'd like to share with us and the community as well. We do appreciate it. So without further ado, I gotta stop looking over here. I gotta look over here. The camera's over here. So without further ado, let's dive into this thing. Yeah, pun intended. Tip number one, here we go. Don't run your battery all the way down, and not for the reasons that you would think. So when you get done diving, you're going to come back, you're going to want to run the maintenance program, and you're going to want to download the footage that you took. The maintenance program that's in the app takes about 10 minutes to run. I myself like to run it twice. I'll put water in a bucket and I will run it for about 10 minutes, and then I dump that water out and run it again. So there's 20 minutes right there of runtime that I need. And at 4K footage, depending on how much you film, on the average, I'm taking about 20-25 minutes to download all the 4K footage onto the SD card so that I can have it and start editing it. So you want to leave about an hour, maybe hour 15 minutes on the battery at least. So that's tip number one that nobody told you about. Again, I'm looking over here. I should be looking over here. If you're ever on a pier and you've got to lower the FiFish down into the water, well, you're going to experience rope burn. You need a nice set of gloves with you. Not because you're going to be bringing slimy stuff up, and you'll be doing that, but you'll need these gloves because you don't want to cut your hands. That's some pretty thin tether there. Bring a hefty garbage bag or two. One, because you're going to be bringing back some nasty stuff from under the water. You don't want that getting inside your truck, so you're going to want something to put it in until you get home and get a chance to clean it up. All your little treasures there. Also, I use the second one to put my FiFish and reel in so that I don't get any salt water inside my truck. So bring a couple heavy duty plastic bags. I would recommend lawn bags actually, because the smaller ones I've actually torn holes in. The last tip I got from my friend Craig Glover, he gave me a great tip, and I'm gonna pass this one on to you, but credit where credit's due. You're going to run into some grass or some seaweed at some point. It's going to get in those motors. The best tool to get it out, this little puppy right here. Get yourself one of these because it gets in there a lot easier to grab that stuff and pull it up than your fingers can get in there. That stuff's a little slimy, and so it's easier to hook it. These come in a set with different ends on them. This one seems to work the best for me. Just kind of get in there and dig that stuff out. Next, the tether reel. If you've ever tried to wind this thing up, you know it's a pain. What I did, you can already see, I removed the extra bar from here, and now it's just a whole lot easier to wind up. So just go ahead and remove that bar, unscrew these two ends, pull it apart a little bit, it'll come sliding right out. Put this back in, you're good to go. Works a whole lot better. A little hard to maneuver in this little kiddie pool. All right, so this is how fast you're going, and it's not enough speed to get you back to where you need to be. Let's just back up here. And we'll go into our rates, and I'll show you what you can do. Now, you can go into sport mode, I know that. Click here, go over to the unit. I don't wanna go into here. Go to customize, and then you have curvature. Want to just raise those up, click sure. All right, come on, click sure. And now, without being in sports mode, because in sports mode you can roll and tip and all that fun stuff, now you can go a lot faster. And you can fight that current, get back. It's not really deep enough here. I keep hitting the bottom. And whenever you're done, just go back, set your curvatures again, bring it back down to where it was. And there you go. Hey guys, this is a big one here for you. So recently I was in the water and I got a calibration error and it just started rolling in the water. So I shut everything out, pulled it out of the water and unscrewed the little 5.5 millimeter bolts that are in, that are holding it in. And as soon as I pulled the arm off, the inserts, well, they stuck inside the arm. I'm gonna put some photos up here so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. I called Dale at Blue Skies Drone Rental and he came to the rescue for me in a big way. So first of all, take the inserts out and of course clean those out and re-thread them, and then you just put epoxy and put those back in. But he has an even better solution than those little screws. He has thumb screws, 5.5 millimeter thumb screws. So no longer do you have to use that stupid little wrench and sit there and crank on that thing for half an hour to get all those things off. Now it's just thumb tight and you are good to go. So there you go. Call Dale, Blue Skies Drone Rental. I'll put a link in the description. It's not an affiliate link. I don't make any money on this or anything like that. I'm just trying to help out the community with the best tools that we possibly can get our hands on.